Struggle of making a thumbnail with a bunch of items. Oh, you can see my highlight. That is amazing. Oh, snap. Hi, everyone. My name is Sarah. I've seen a lot of these videos called books that I'm thankful for around BookTube and stuff, and I'm pretty sure this is also a thing as well. But for today's video, because Thanksgiving is next Thursday, I wanted to do a movies that I'm thankful for. Now, all of these movies I don't own myself. I've seen them like on Netflix and stuff, or I've streamed them. And overall, I think I have 12. So let's just get into it and let's talk about movies. Okay, so the first one I want to talk about, this is so weird. My family actually owns the VHS of it, and this is exactly what I watched it on. So this is Annie with Albert Finney, Carol Burnett, Bernadette Peters, Anne Rankin, and Tim Curry with Aileen Quinn, I think that's her name. If I had to give a movie that described my childhood, it would probably have to be this version of Annie, because this is literally what I grew up on. Ever since I was a kid, I think about her age, I think it was about like 10. 9, 10-ish, 8 maybe. As you guys know, I've always loved musical theater. It's always been a part of my life, but this is my first dream role. I think one of the things that this movie has taught me is that being, this is gonna be really sad, but she's orphaned. So she's been abandoned and rejected and mistreated all her life. And that doesn't have to be your way of seeing life. You don't have to think negatively. There's always something positive, even if you're in a really bad situation. Plus, I always had my sister playing Molly. So she told me, the thing that movie taught me was that I was always your sidekick. Thanks, Rachel. Next movie is also on a VHS. We're just going through my childhood right now. If you guys have been on my channel for a while and seen a couple of my videos, you would know that this is the movie that I saw when I was, oh my gosh, how old was I? I don't know. This movie helped me realize my passion for bringing stories to life. And that is Little Women with Winona Ryder and Susan Sarandon and like little Kristen Dunst and Claire Danes, y'all. That's Trini Alvarado. I know names. Also Christian Bale and Gabriel Byrne's in this. It was really odd. Anyway, if you don't know, I spent an entire summer of one of my childhood years reenacting this entire film, like, to its entirety. I dressed up, I like made firewood, I burnt candles, I had my sisters and me make like this old-fashioned newspaper. I just wanted to be Joe in real life. And when I realized that pretending that it's winter inside my room when it's summer, like California summer outside in the middle of like August and July, not the healthiest thing for this child. But I really wanted to bring the story to life because I related to her so much and I really wanted her to be real in me. So thank you, who directed this? Gillian Armstrong. Thank you, Gillian Armstrong, for making this, directing it, and you changed this girl's life, whoever you are. Strong female lead. So this one, if y'all know me like in real life or online, this is gonna be super obvious. I've talked about this movie several times. You've seen this DVD a lot on this channel. Aladdin. Hello. What? Of course, if you didn't know, I love this movie. When I was about 12, I spent an entire Saturday watching the entire, like, this second disc was my entire Saturday that day. And I relate to the characters in this, specifically Aladdin, not Jasmine. Aladdin. And it's also kind of like the Annie thing where even if you're in a really bad situation, it doesn't have to be that way. One of the songs that really, well, actually two songs that really hit me with this movie. One of them actually made it into the film, the other one didn't, and is actually in the Broadway musical version. Love that too. You'd think it's like A Whole New World or something, but it's actually not. It's One Jump Ahead Reprise. Bizarre, random, what 12-year-old actually likes the reprise of something? If you guys don't know, it's the one that goes, "Riff raff, street rat, I don't buy that. If only they look closer, would they see a poor boy? No siree, they'd find out there's so much more to me." That was me as a child. If they give me the opportunity to see what I see in myself, I wouldn't be really depressed right now. That's really sad and self-deprecating. Also, Genie is my dream role. Current, please hire me. And the second one is Proud of Your Boy. If you guys have not heard that song, the first time I heard it was on this first disc, the second disc, I don't know, but the Clay Aiken version is the first time I ever heard the song. And it's just him making a promise to his mom that he's gonna make her proud of her boy. It's beautiful. Oh my gosh. I'll talk about this more over the next weekend because it's the 25th anniversary of Aladdin next Saturday, so stay tuned for that video. This next movie I actually don't own, but I saw it recently on Netflix, so it's on Netflix right now. If you haven't seen this, go watch it. Oh my gosh, I'm like so upset that I haven't watched this movie until few months ago, and it's Dead Poets Society starring Robin Williams. Where has this been all my life? Basically, the thing I love about this film is that Robin Williams' character opened up this whole world to these young high school guys. I wrote it down on here, so I just have to read it from my notes. It deals with young guys who find themselves in poetry and stand up for what they believe in. And it's really cool how art, like literature and like performance art and just art in general, can inspire youth and this generation to like really stand up for themselves against a generation who probably doesn't see it that way. Plus, when I saw it, I cried at 2 a.m. So, and if you've seen the movie and you know me, you'll see why. This next one is a bit bizarre. I didn't have a favorite movie until I saw this movie, and it is Lemonade Mouth. Yes, a Disney Channel original movie. The one that everyone was like, oh yeah, that movie, or I've never seen it because it came after High School Musical and I didn't care between High School Musical and Camp Rock. Like, everything else didn't matter. How people describe this movie is basically like The Breakfast Club forming a band. What I'm thankful for in this movie in particular is Hayley Kiyoko's character named Stella. One, she's an Asian American represented on screen, so thank you so much for diversity in this film. Also, her character is that she's, again, I just connect with characters that are just different from everyone around them. She's different from her family, and she's really passionate about making music and just really rocking people's lives. And she doesn't let anything stop her from doing that. A lot of things come her way and she's still stable and unshaken, and she's just like, nope, we're going for this, guys. Even if I'm alone at this. Be nice if you guys came along, but we're gonna make this happen. And because of her determination, they make it. And it's so awesome. Okay, this one is just for me, but I'm thankful for this movie. Of course, Spider-Man Homecoming. Thank you for making it right. Thank you for getting it right. Thank you for Tom Holland. Thank you for, literally, thank you for Jacob Batalon. I love him. He's amazing. I love Spider-Man. And this just like captures the essence of Spider-Man in its entirety. It's just brilliant. If you haven't seen it, what are you doing? Go watch it. Or watch it with me because I have the DVD. This one's a bit odd as well, but I am very thankful for High School Musical. I didn't know if I wanted to put this one in this list, but I think that High School Musical came at the very right time in this world. It was like, what in the world is Maddie from The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody doing here looking like this? The characters were closer to my age, not exactly, but they were closer to my age, and it made this musical so much more relatable to me, especially when it came out and in the time of my life. This movie is kind of unheard of as well because it's a Christian film, but Grace Unplugged, it stars AJ Mashalka. This film is about a girl who has grown up in a Christian home and Christian environment, and she wants to make it big, like in the music world, so she tries that for a bit. She kind of gets sucked in. And for me, as a Christian artist as well, and seeing a portrayal of that in a film, it meant so much more to me, and it didn't discourage me from continuing in my dreams of just going beyond church. God won't get mad if you break out of church, like, oh no, you're trying to make music outside of church, I'm disappointed in you, lightning bolt, lightning bolt. If you're called to it, there's no way you can't make it. That. Meet the Robinsons. Oh my gosh, very underrated. One of the things that I got from this movie is that words will change the world. If you've seen this movie, you know what scene I'm talking about at the end. If you haven't seen it, watch it, then you'll know what scene I'm talking about at the end. And it's also about adoption. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful. Being unique doesn't have to be bad. And again, this guy is just, this is the star of the film. He stays optimistic about his life, and in time, he finds his family, and he finds people that he connects with. Another VHS going backwards, Mulan, because, of course, like, female warrior princess who is hardcore at everything, and, like, literally fights a war, and wins, hello. She's not doing it for a man. Well, okay, that's not entirely true. It's her dad, but not a man that she's, like, romantically interested. She doesn't need like a love interest. She just does it for her family. She does it for herself to find out who she is. Plus Leia Salonga. Back to VHS's again. This, I think, is another movie that describes my childhood because Pocahontas was my goal in life. I'm pretty sure she's my favorite Disney princess next to Mulan. But this is very important. This movie is very important to me as a child. Clearly, I'm not a very light-skinned person, and seeing her on screen and doing really cool like legit strong female lead-ish kind of things was life altering for me as a child, because I literally look up to her because I was little and the TV was up there. Thank you, Disney, for making this film for this child, because literally touched me as well. More of these, please. Also, bring these to Broadway. Imagine these on Broadway. Oh, snap. Okay, last two. I gotta keep this one short. Princess Diaries. You can be yourself, and even if you're quirky and clumsy and awkward and you end up being the Princess of Genovia, you can take on responsibilities and it's gonna be okay. It's very relatable to me personally, because I'm not the brightest one in the toolbox. And the last one that I don't own as well is Penelope, starring James McAvoy, Christina Ricci. But it's also on Netflix, so go watch that one as well. This one was very different to me when I first saw it. It's about loving yourself, and loving yourself conquers or like overrides love from family, friends, and like any possible love interests. And it's one you can build up on your own. You don't need anybody to build that up for you. You don't need anybody to trigger that for you. And that message just came at a very, very important time in my life. It's very powerful. Oh my wow. And those are the films that I am thankful for. I'm so sorry this video is super long. I'm gonna try to not make it that long during editing. Oh my gosh, let's see. But that is all I have for today's video. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If there are any movies that you're thankful for, let me know in the comments below. Also, if you want me to do another one of these with like books or musicals or, you know, anything else, let me know in the comments below as well. Also, if you want to send that to me over social media, I have those. You can check them out in the down bar below. Also, you can subscribe to this channel where I'll be posting videos every Wednesday and Saturday. Next Saturday is a super, super, super exciting one. Please stay in tune for that one because I'm so excited. Aladdin 25th anniversary. All right, cool. That's it. Thank you guys for hanging out with me today. I will see you guys next time. Have a great Thanksgiving. See ya on Wednesday. Bye!